The mother of a little boy killed by his father in a murder-suicide in Lismore says her son was taken by the person he should have been able to trust the most. The two-year-old was poisoned at his dad's home on Sunday, an act described today as evil and cowardly. Here's Natasha Squarey.
Well, Rowan has been described as a beautiful and joyful young boy who loved music and the beach, touching the hearts of everyone lucky enough to be in his world. His mother, Dr. Sophie Room, and his entire family has been left utterly devastated after the two-year-old's father, James Harrison, killed himself and his son. Harrison and Dr. Room broke up last year. Harrison had planned custody visits, but on Sunday he never returned Rowan to his mother. She went to police an hour after he was meant to be home, but there was no answer at Harrison's property. Officers left and called his relatives before returning to the address 4 hours later to find the two bodies.
It's an evil act. It's just an evil act. I'm horrified by it.
The boy's family says their suffering is immense. Rowan's life was ended by an evil and cowardly act of violence perpetrated by a person he should have been able to trust the most.
It's completely heartbreaking. I can only imagine what that mum's going through today.
Today there was further distress when a manager at New South Wales Health emailed Harrison's colleagues, describing the killer as a wonderful colleague and a proud dad. The health minister said this tribute was not endorsed by his department.
We want to make sure that we as a health family wrap our arms around her.
Harrison was slapped with an AVO to protect Dr. Room in August last year, and it was extended just 3 months ago, but little Rowan wasn't named on the order. His family says he'll be loved and missed forever.
71 people are being treated in hospital in Bangkok, including 8 Australians, after a terrifying mid-air plunge on a flight from London to Singapore. A British man died in the emergency. Chief Reporter Chris Reason has the latest.
Good afternoon. Passengers saying it was a terrifying and wild ride as the Singapore Airlines jet was literally tossed around in the sky, with confirmation that 56 passengers on board were Australian, 8 of them having to be hospitalised. Singapore's SQ321 from London hit severe turbulence on approach to Singapore about 10 hours into the flight. Breakfast was being served at the time. Any passengers not strapped in were thrown around the cabin, along with the trolleys, trays and cutlery. You can see the chaos from these photos taken on board. The plane immediately diverted to Bangkok, landing 8:35 local time to a virtual airside hospital on the tarmac. A total 71 people were injured, with confirmation that 73-year-old British grandfather Jeffrey Ralph Kitchen was killed, believed to have died from a heart attack. Passengers describing the nightmare on board.
The plane starts shaking, and at that point, like, I just know that, okay, well, I'm just gonna like huddle in, but like it kept getting worse and worse and worse. I saw people from across the aisle just like going completely horizontal, hitting the ceiling.
It's a terrible experience that these people have gone through.
Online flight tracking apps show that the Boeing 777 endured what US reports described as a bucking bronco flight path, rising and falling some 6,000 feet or 2 kilometres in just a few minutes, though some experts say that could well have been the pilots trying to descend to safer low levels. The cause, either convection currents from nearby storms or possible clear air turbulence as the plane hit jet streams, both very hard to detect. Research out of Britain last year showed there had been a marked increase in clear air turbulence incidents in recent years, with predictions from weather experts that will only get worse with climate change.
A teenager has been charged this afternoon over a boat crash that killed a girl at Grays Point. The 16-year-old victim was riding in a vessel on Australia Day when it's alleged it collided with another tinny, sending her flying into the water. She was taken to St George Hospital, but she couldn't be saved. A 16-year-old boy will face court next month for operating a recreational vessel, negligently causing death. A new rescue mission is due to depart Noumea in the coming hours after the first plane load of relieved Australians returned home. Steve Hart with the story.
Yes, that's right, and Australian officials are working to make sure stranded Aussies are on board after 2 successful flights by the Air Force yesterday. Hercules aircraft was sent from the RAF base to bring 108 Australians safely back. At the airport, there were big hugs and cheers, even selfies on the tarmac after getting off the planes. All were very relieved to be back home after becoming stranded for days during the riots. People told us they could hear gunshots and explosions, and there was difficulty getting food.
Just went foraging. So we just walked the streets, got up before curfew and stepped out over curfew and went to see what we could find.
All the locals were just going to this one supermarket. The shelves were completely empty. We were lining up for like 1 hour just to get a baguette.
One day that was beautiful, and then after that it just turned ugly.
On last night's flights, we also met American, Canadian and British citizens who were able to board the flight and get out of Noumea. The next flight out of Noumea to Brisbane is expected to arrive later this evening.
The French president and three of his senior government officials are right now headed to New Caledonia for a fly-in, fly-out show of force. Emmanuel Macron will visit for 24 hours, attempting to restart talks between Paris and pro-independence protesters in Noumea at odds over voting reforms. The peak body for unions has called for a 5% pay rise for the lowest paid workers, with the Fair Work Commission meeting in Sydney today for its annual wage review hearing. The ACTU wants a minimum 4% increase for employees in female-dominated sectors, such as childcare and disability support.
We're saying that because times are really tough for working people. They're finding it really hard to make ends meet, and we know that wages have only just started to go up.
I would like a pay rise, the 5% pay rise, so that I can have a life outside of work.
The Business Council is pushing for the minimum wage to increase by 2% and has warned anything higher could push up inflation. The Shadow Treasurer has made a huge call on migration that would see the opposition make even deeper cuts than it promised last week in its budget reply. Live to Ben Downey in Canberra. Ben, good afternoon. Angus Taylor has gone further than his party leader.
Yes, and good afternoon. He said there would be a 25% cut to net overseas migration, not just permanent migration, when pressed at the National Press Club. What does this mean? Stopping around a further 50,000 migrants coming in, because the first figure, permanent migration, it only takes into account people coming here for good, whereas net overseas migration, this latest figure, takes into account every visa category, students, expats, backpackers and more. The cut over 3 years would free up even more homes than Peter Dutton promised, but raises further questions about how to fill skill shortages to build them.
We've said over the coming years we'll achieve a 25% reduction in the NOM versus what Labor has...
The permanent migration
number? That's the NOM. And so that's a reasonable number, for we think, to achieve.
The centrepiece of Peter Dutton's budget reply is now a smoking ruin because of Angus Taylor's speech.
Coalition's plan for nuclear energy also came under fire after the nation's peak science body, the CSIRO, commissioned a report finding it would cost as much as 2.5 times the amount of renewables with storage and take 15 years to build compared to projects already in the pipeline.
There's no doubt it will be more challenging to hit our emission targets, if you like, using nuclear power.
Lots of people bandy numbers around nuclear and other energy sources. I mean, ultimately, the numbers that I take the most notice of are the ones that people invest in and investors focus on.
Angus Taylor says the locations of the nuclear plants will be unveiled in the coming months. Anne.
Ben Dunn in Canberra. Thank you, Ben. A Greenacre bakery is being widely condemned after making a cake that featured a Hamas terrorist for a 4-year-old's birthday. Oven Bakery by Fufu shared images of the cake and cupcakes to their Instagram account, with a boy posing dressed in a similar outfit. Premier Chris Minns said the image was horrifying and said Hamas was an evil terrorist organisation. The Australian Jewish group say it's reprehensible and a form of abuse. Angie Asimus joins us now with the latest on our weather. Hi there, Angie. Beautiful out in the sunshine today.
And today was just spectacular. Look at this. Barely a cloud in the sky. The harbour city just sparkled, bathed in all that sunshine. and we had the temperatures to match. It may have been a cool start, but we ended up with a lovely top of 21 degrees. Statewide, south to southwesterly winds weren't overly gusty, but there was still a wind chill factor, so you could shave a few degrees off these maximums for the feels-like temperature. The reason for the run of fine weather is that slow-moving high still sitting over near the Bight. That high will gradually weaken in the coming days, only to be replaced with another similar system. So if we take a look at current conditions around the suburbs, that wind chill still a factor. It is 19 degrees at Manly at the moment, feels like 14. It's 12 degrees at Katoomba, but feels closer to 9. The next chance of some wet weather is going to be over the weekend.